because it's a far right ethno state, because it's a far right ethno state, because it's a far right ethno state. Ideas have consequences. And on a much different note, a obscure white nationalist who I've never heard of named Mark Collette.
He's a BNP guy.
Who is a BNP, British National Party, which is a thug fascist, heirs to the brown shirts in the UK. You know, loathsome group. Yeah, let's do a little background.
Think of a bundle of twigs. If you take a bundle of twigs and try to break them over your leg, what do you do? You just get a sore leg. You're not breaking them. But once you split that bundle and you end up with individual twigs, you end up with a lot of individually weak pieces that can all be broken. Now, when you think of our people as a bundle, it is in fact the culture, the heritage, and the traditions that act as the glue that bind us together. Now, what we have lost here in the West, and this is something the left has done a great job of, you see, the left grants in-group preference and identity to many groups, to homosexuals, to transgenders, to Muslims, to Afro-Caribbeans, to all manner of people. But the one group of people that have had their traditions, culture, and identity taken away from them, the one group of people that are not allowed an in-group preference, is those of European descent who believe in traditionalism. And the problem is, we have become scattered like twigs. We no longer have a community. And because of that, we are increasingly being seen as effective prey for those who have retained their cultures, heritage, and tradition, remain as a group, have strong in-group preference, and stick together. The left understand the power of things like in-group preference. They understand the power of identity and culture. That's why they grant it to our enemies, but take it away from us.
Some interesting points there. I did notice the bundle of sticks reference, which does come from Mussolini. I do recall that. So
that's this guy. And unlike Nomiki, he does not confuse volume with argument. And that, of course, makes him appreciate Tucker Carlson's work.
And I've seen Tucker Carlson use the term white genocide. And when I first started using it, I remember some of the people closest to me said, you can't use that, you can't use that. I said, it's actually true. It's what's actually happening. And I read them the UN document, and, you know, they were forced into agreeing, but they still said, I think you're going to scare people off. I think you're going too far. But I disagree. I disagreed then, and I'm very proud that myself and others who have used that term managed to influence the mainstream media and people like Tucker Carlson into using that term. But that's what sets people like Tucker apart.
Former Bush campaign strategist and ABC News political analyst Matthew Dowd went further than that. He published an op-ed demanding that, quote, white male Christians vacate their positions of power for other people. He's not doing that himself, but he did not notably advocate for genocide. A Georgetown professor called Christine Fair did do that.
Oh, right,
she recently tweeted this, quote, look at this chorus of entitled white men justifying a serial rapist's arrogated entitlement. All of them deserve miserable deaths while feminists laugh as they take their last gasps. Bonus, we castrate their corpses and feed them to swine. Yes.
Ew.
Georgetown has issued a statement defending Fair. Of course they have. Marjorie Clifton is the founder of Clifton.
Okay. So, I mean, look, you know, that's... I would say he's still in the realm of plausible deniability there. In some ways, this guy's using, he's using what Tucker's pointing to and taking across the finish line a little bit.
Collette. Oh, well, yeah. I mean, that's how it works.
That's
though, right?
how it
that's
works.
That's how Piccolini
yeah. says. That's how the whole thing works. I mean, that's what Tucker's doing literally every night.
Secret message received.
Yeah, on Daily Stormer, yeah. Tucker is absolutely lapping everyone else on Fox News. He has been featured in 265 Daily Stormer articles between November 2016 and November 2018. And far behind him, Hannity with 27, Ingram with 4,
Ingram.
New Jobs with 2.
Damn, Ingram's thirsty for it, too.
Yeah, what's
yeah,
going on?
Come on, guys. Don't be
yeah, Ingram.
So misogynist.
That's
here.
Embarrassing. All right, I want to talk about this briefly. Mark Lamont Hill, He's been around for a while. He's an academic. He's a commentator. He's an activist. And he, like those of us who share universal principles, is an advocate for democracy for the Palestinian people who suffer in a siege in Gaza, an occupation and apartheid in the West Bank, and are not, it is definitely a different situation inside 67 borders in Israel, but they are certainly not fully equal citizens inside what is an ethnostate. Now, the justifications as far for ethnostates, as far as they go, Israel is the best justification imaginable. The Jews are one of the most highly repressed groups in human history, and coming out of World War II, had literally just had millions of people murdered in the Holocaust by Nazi Germany. So there's an origin here, there's a history here, and there is, of course, still an incredible potency in global anti-Semitism. But the reality is that the Israeli state not only is profoundly repressive of Palestinians, it's also been increasingly aligning, because it's a far-right ethnostate, with those same far-right, traditionally anti-Semitic forces, particularly in Europe, in countries like Hungary. So Mark Lamont Hill addressed a conference at the UN, and he called for Palestinians to have full and complete democracy. And he actually called specifically for a binational state of democracy and openness for all those in Israel, Palestine. I think that this is where, frankly, this is the most idealistic position to have. This is the position that someone like Tony Judt had, who was a great social democrat and Jewish intellectual.
Read his stuff. Very good.
Very good. And it's the recognition that if you believe in an anti-essentialist cosmopolitan politics, you don't believe in an ethno-state of any kind. You don't believe in leadership, built on identity, frankly. Of course, you believe in anti-colonization and national self-determination, but fundamentally, you don't want to build a country on any exclusivist identity, whether it's in Iran, Pakistan, or Israel. And no matter how fundamentally even, one might sympathize with a group like the Jewish people who have been on the receiving end of enormous repression and abuse, we oppose that. And I would say I noticed that in the Tucker clip, where Tucker's, in my opinion, a crypto-Nazi who's drawing obscene false equivalencies, but I think he's going to get a lot of mileage out of an essentialist turn in politics, which I totally oppose.